The skin inside the ear canal, imagine it growing like a conveyor belt. It's trying to always get to the outermost portion of the ear canal to come away really easily. Now, what happens in this case is it kind of stays in situ and dehydrates and hardens up, and that's what we call keratin. Now, that's what we've got at the base of this canal. Now, with keratosis obturans, what happens is those layers of dry, hardened skin add to one another. So what that effectively does then is you've got this ever widening plug of skin, and it starts putting pressure on the canal walls, okay, which causes a kind of like a chronic inflammation, if you like, in there. Now, what can happen in extreme cases is it causes the bone around the ear canal, the bony portion of the ear canal, to start what they call resorption. So basically, it just starts almost wearing away of the bone tissue, if you like, that bone eardrum. And what can happen with these particular ear canals is you start to get almost like a ballooning, a widening of the canal wall. So it starts to look much, much wider than it should do. Now, if that happens to the whole ear canal, we talk about ear canal remodeling, which is basically where it just kind of forms this much, much wider canal overall.